recording?
Yep.
Video?
Yep.
Alright. So if anybody blows up, you'll have it on tape.
At this point, I'm starting to realize that the computer probably needs to be flashed. There's a security lockout on these computers where if the key is not in the ignition that matches it to this computer, that the car will not start. So I could do this work myself, but it probably costs about twice as much as having somebody else who knows what they're doing do it. So I'm going to go do some searching. So far, I found an individual named Sinister who can do this work for me, and I think I'm going to send it off to him. So I just got the computer back today. I've installed it in the car, and I am ready to test out this new flash and see if it works.
And power to the fuel pump. Got the fuel pump running. Get some fuel flowing. And this is my starter wire. We got fuel flowing. Got power. You ready?
And as you see, it didn't seem to work. So there must be something else I need to troubleshoot. Back to the drawing board. So after multiple attempts at trying to start this car, I started doing the normal troubleshooting, which was checking for spark. And when I disconnected spark plug cable, I started noticing that oil was shooting out of a hole where this rubber hose currently is. It seems as though the oil pressure sending unit was not installed. I've installed this rubber hose for now just to keep the oil from leaking out any further, but I needed to go get a oil sending unit for this car. So this is the plug that attaches to the sending unit, and I'm going to go ahead and get that installed. I don't know if that's going to cause the computer to lock out. I guess that zero oil pressure may keep the computer from allowing the car to start, but we'll see. So this is the sending unit I just picked up, and I'm going to get this installed, and let's see what happens.
So I removed the rubber hose I stuck in there to keep it from leaking oil everywhere, and I installed the oil pressure sensor and attach the cable. And let's see if that solves the problem.
It's stuck.
Gotta pull it up.
I know, I mean it like...
All right, so in troubleshooting the spark plug, or the lack of spark, from this cylinder, I discovered that I did not have power to the pink lead on the coil pack. That requires 12 volts. I thought I had traced it out to that big block which goes to the firewall. I thought I had the right pinout, but I did not have 12 volts here. No 12 volts at the coil pack, no high voltage. So I took the entire harness apart here, took all the wires apart, traced it back out, and found out, oh, there is a wire that still went to that junction box that did not have 12 volts in it. So now you see it over there on the switch, it's been attached. That is the pink wire that goes here and provides voltage. So now I have guaranteed that I actually have voltage there when I flip the switch and add power. So let's try it again.
Yes, I heard it. It actually tried to turn over. Sounds like it may be a little bit short on fuel, so let's get the fuel pump reattached and give it another try.
Let's